vigorous by love, and gained the flying fleet, and clasped, unwelcome guest, the Gnossian poop. Here soon her father spied her, in the air he winged his way, now clothed with yellow plumes of falcon, and down darted, with his beak so curved to wound her as she clung. In dread her grasp she loosed, and as she seemed to fall, the light air bore her from the waves below. Plumed she became, and formed a feathered bird. Cyrus they called her, from the ravished lock. To Jove now Minos all his vows performs, an hecatomb of bulls, as from the fleet he lands on Knossos' shores, his royal hall with all his spoils on high uphung adorned. Meantime the probrim of his bed increased, the two-formed monster in a novel birth at length the mother's beastly crime proclaimed. Minos, the shameful witness from his couch, far to remove determines. In a dome intricate winding he resolves to lodge, from every eye concealed, the birth, entrusts the work to Daedalus, in cunning arts most famed to build. He all the various marks confuses, puzzles, bent on either side the various paths confound the searching eye. So in the fields the soft meander plays, here refluent, flowing there with dubious course. Meeting himself, his wandering stream he sees, and urges now to whence he first arose, now to the open outlet of the main. Thus Daedalus, the numerous paths perplexed, with puzzlings intricate, so much entwined, himself could scarce the outer threshold gain. Here was the double monster, man and bull enclosed, till by the third allotted tribe the ninth year vanquished, with Athenian blood twice gorged before. Then was the secret gate, so often sought in vain, found by the aid a virgin lent to trace the winding clue. Instant for Dias, Theseus loosed his sails, with Minos's ravished daughter. On that shore, cruel, he left her. The deserted nymph, wildly lamenting, Bacchus soon embraced, and gave her needful aid. Her fame to fix, immortal in the skies, her sparkling crown moved from her forehead, mid the stars he placed.